Yes! Okay. So the engine is currently completely running on Speeduino. As you can see, it's not very good running engine. And we got a check engine, but it's actually working! Yes!
A while back, I purchased a Speeduino version 0.4.3C DIY kit. I've chosen Speeduino because of the extremely budget-friendly price, the DIY feeling it has, and I'm a big supporter of open source projects. This was my first soldering project with through-hole components, so the result was not very pretty, but it should do the job.
I've started preparations for the Speeduino install. And instead of using this IEC40 connector, I'm thinking of using the OEM connectors. This is an auto ECU, which I don't need. And of course it has the stock connectors, which I can remove and use it for the connections. And also these are the OEM connectors for the ECU. And what I'm currently doing is I'm deepening some of the connectors, and I'm going to use the exactly the same wire colors for the connectors to the standalone ECU. Doing this just pretty much because I want to, and I think it will be neat and easy to troubleshoot, if anything else, because the colors will be the same as on the stock wiring loom. And you can deepen these by just lifting this part. When you lift this part, you can just take these pins out. They are quite tight, but they come out when pulled. So decided to use these two connectors, which should be plenty enough for the Speeduino pins. So in total they have around 50 pins, I think. So yeah, I'm going to use the E-pin, what is marked in the service manual, and the D-pin. And I'm going to populate them with appropriate colored pins. That would be much easier to troubleshoot because they'll be the same, exact same colors as in the manual.
Before populating the connectors with pins, I've made an Excel spreadsheet with color-coded diagrams of the connectors with corresponding functions of the pins. This helped to put the pins into the right slots and provide great reference material for later on.
Just finished this monstrosity. It's not pretty, but I checked and there are no shorts here, and hopefully this will work. It, as you can see, it has now the OEM Lexus plugs and corresponding colored wires. And hopefully soon we'll add this to the Lexus and try to see if the ECU sees crank sensors and everything, all the sensors, and then wire in the ignition and the fuel to see if it runs.
The next step was to install the firmware and download the bass tune for Tuner Studio using Speeduloader. Then I've started a new project in Tuner Studio, chosen some basing settings, and that was it. Finally, the Speeduino was alive and connected to the tuning software. Now was the time to go through all of the settings and do appropriate changes for the 1GFE. I think I'll do a separate video about the settings once I've got the car sorted, because currently most of them are guesses and placeholders.
So finally, the Lexus is back in the garage and it's time to do the wiring. Previously it had that 3 piggyback installed, that's why some wires are already spliced or cut. And yeah, got the Speeduino, the standard wiring, the manual, and the pinout that I made for the connections on the Speeduino that I've got. So now it's only time to find the correct colors and connect them. And now my idea is to connect all of these sensors, so that's like coolant temperature, air temperature, crank position, and don't connect the injectors or the ignition coils. Leave it to the stock ECU, and just after I connect the sensors, see if the Speeduino sees all of the sensors correct, then add the injectors and ignition coils. So time for me to work, and I'll see you when something is connected. Connected the power and ground, and also one of the sensors. The easiest one to test was the intake air temperature sensor. So it's out. As you can see, it shows now something like 5 degrees or so. And if I pick up and heat it with my hand, you'll see that the temperature starts to climb bit by bit. Yeah, 12 degrees, 13 degrees, and so on. So it seems to be working. Good. Now I need to connect all the rest of these sensors and test them out also if they are working. So everything is working, it seems. At least the sensor that I connected. The throttle works. And I'm going to try to start now and see if the Speeduino sees the engine speed. I saw that the Speeduino saw sync, and the engine speed was like 120 something RPMs. Success, and I think that's enough for today. So got the engine running, and as you can see, it sees all the parameters, it's syncing. Yeah, everything seemed to be good. Like all of the sensors are seen by the ECU. I think it's time to swap the injectors and the ignition coil signals to the Speeduino and see if it starts on Speeduino. Once again, I've referenced with my Excel spreadsheet with the color-coded pins as well as the manual with the colors. And now I've got the injectors paired as they should be, and also I've connected the ignition coils, as you can see here. And now all of the things in relation to the engine is now connected to the Speeduino, and it should start right now on the standalone. Okay, so let's try to start it. Let's see if it will. Okay, another attempt. I've slightly redone the wiring, added a fresh battery, so maybe it will start this time. Nope, nothing. Interesting. Went to the back and I can smell petrol from the tailpipe, so the injectors are working, so maybe it is an ignition problem. I just went through all of the spark plugs and all of them had some gasoline smell, so that means the injectors are working somewhat at least. So my next move is to check for ignition, taking out the spark plug and seeing if it fires. And if there is spark, that means that the trigger pattern settings are wrong. Maybe the firing angle is wrong or something along those lines. But first we need to check for the easy to diagnose things. I just checked the footage and I can see that the first cylinder coil is getting power and the spark plug is generating a spark. So I have to check all of the other holes and to see if all of the other holes get it. If I see sparks in all of the cylinders, then it means that there is probably something wrong with these settings most likely in the trigger wheel and timing. Let me go through all of these and I'll see you when I'm done with that. I've checked all of the cylinders and all of them show some spark. I think the spark was pretty good, at least from the camera. And now the only questions left is if the spark is firing at the correct time. And I don't know how I'm going to check that by myself, because as you can imagine, using a timing light and turning the key at the same time is quite difficult when these two things are like a meter apart. But I will try something to rig the camera and the timing light, and hopefully we can see if at least the spark is at the somewhat thumb dead center of the first cylinder.
Since some of the screens did not get recorded when I was trying to explain this at the garage, I'll do the explanation right now. So first thing to do when you're trying to determine the offset angle with a timing light is to change the settings in Spark and to enable fixed or locked timing. What this does is without this setting, the timing might change. You know, it might fire, let's say at 11 degrees, then at 8, and it can bounce around a bit. So to fix it, you put the setting on and you add the angle. This depends on what kind of markings do you have on your pulley. For example, on the Lexus, you have a zero mark, and there are some additional marks at like 5, 10, 15 maybe degrees on the timing cover. Then in between cranking attempts, what you do is you go to settings, go to trigger setup and change this value. This is the trigger angle in degrees, and as the tooltip says, this is the angle after top dead center when tooth number one on the primary wheel passes the primary sensor. And this is from the manual. This is the readout you would get if you added an oscilloscope to the sensors while the engine is idling. These are the tooths on the crank angle position sensor wheel, and if you count them, there would be 34 tooth, and you can see that there are gaps in between these. So these are the missing tooth, and in the Lexus case, you have two teeth missing, and this is the number one tooth, as well as this one is the number one tooth. And what we need to add to the ECU is the angle between this tooth and when the first cylinder fires, and you can test that with a timing light, because when you change the trigger angle, what you do is you change whenever the coil fires. So if you had 0 degrees, the ECU would determine this is number one tooth because of the gap that it had previously. The ECU would fire the spark here, but of course the top dead center maybe is over here somewhere. So you need to offset it by some particular amount. And you test that with a timing light. By changing the angle, you know, you can start maybe at 0, at 90, 180, and try to look if the marks on the pulley and the timing cover match. I've collected all of the frames from the three different ignition angles I've tried. And as you can see in the middle, it was the first one. It was at 200 degrees. You can see that the mark on the pulley is at around 5 degrees. Then when I added 5 degrees, the mark pushed even further away, probably to the 10 mark, even though you can't really see it. And then when I reduced by 5 from 200 to 195, the zero mark is exactly at the mark on the pulley, which means that the ignition timing is correct.
This is how I managed to measure the ignition timing on my own. So I zip tied the ignition timing light to the block, and you can see a GoPro over there, which films the crank pulley with the marks. And then, of course, I upload it to the computer and then scroll to the correct frame to see what was the ignition timing.
Later on, I've reversed the control of the engine from the Speeduino back to the stock ECU because I had a assumption that there were still some syncing problems. Even though the bar would show that like it is full sync, I think it had some problems. So what I did is I've once again turned the engine with the stock ECU, and while it was running, I started to use the composite logger and log whatever the Speeduino saw. And if it saw, you know, false triggers, if it saw the camshaft or the crankshaft signals correctly, and I've started to change the trigger settings. Mainly, I didn't know if I was using the correct rising or falling edge, and in the end it seems that rising was the correct one. And also I've changed this lever for first phase. This means that whether the ECU checks for a high signal on the cam sensor or low signal on the cam sensor. And low seemed to work out in the end. I'm still not sure if the settings are truly correct, but it did get the engine started.
Yes! Okay. So the engine is currently completely running on Speeduino. As you can see, it's not very good running engine. And it got a check engine, but it's actually working! Yes! Yes! It's running! Finally! And it kind of idles. But that's gonna be later, like that's tuning stuff. I got the engine running on a standalone. Yes! Okay, I will not poison myself with carbon monoxide anymore. Finally, the engine is actually running on Speeduino. It took me probably like a whole week of like everyday tinkering to get to this point because I've had some syncing issues, but now I think everything is sorted. The engine is running and it will only need to be tuned. But that's gonna be much, much, much later after I get the turbo ride here.